Hello students, today we are going to see how to write blog. Blog writing is very important topic or unit in your textbook. It is very important for 11th as well as 12th standard. So what is blog? Blog is a discussion or informational website published on the World Wide Web. This is a part of social media. Before blog writing became popular, people used to write or share their articles, write-ups, etc. through various media. These are newspapers, television, radio, internet, magazines, etc. So in this way, if you want to share your idea, discussions, information, to others, blog is used. This has a structure, a typical structure. So how it is written, what is the blog structure, or there are some steps we have to follow while writing blog. We are going to see in this lecture. So very important topic, blog writing. Here I am going to tell you. Let me see what is a blog. If you have books, you can see on page number 102 or 103. 11th standard. A blog is a shortening, if we can call it web blog. It is an online journal or informational website displaying information in the reverse chronological order, with latest posts appearing first. It is a platform where a writer or even a group of writers share their views on an individual subject. Each entry is called a post. So to share your ideas, your opinion, your information, any kind of information, blog is very impressive kind of structure you can use here. This is also called a part of social media. On this way, blog structure we are going to see. See, for example, the appearance of blog changed over the course of time. Most blogs include some standard features and structure. Here are some common features we are going to see. Typical blog will include, this is first a header with the menu or navigation bar. Let me tell you, this is this type of header or navigation bar is used. Then there is main content area with highlighted or latest blog posts. In this way, you can write here your blog, the blog post. This is the navigation bar or header, you can say it. Then there is sidebar with social profiles, favorite content or call to action. Here it will be the sidebar, and here you can add social profiles, favorite content or call to action. And there is footer with relevant links like a disclaimer, privacy policy, contact page, etc. The footer. So this is the structure of blog writing, and in this way you can present your blog, you can present your information, any discussion through this way. Here is a list of reasons why people blog and how blogging can benefit your personal or professional life. What is the importance of blog, or why it is used, why people use it? There are some reasons. For example, express yourself and share your passions. Very important thing that you can express yourself through this blog. Make a difference. So if you have any idea, any important kind of ideas or your post, blog post, you can make difference through this way. Share interesting information. You can share information in this way. Refine your writing skills. Learn how to make money online. This is one another way why blog is very important, why blog is used most of the times here on social media. Build your professional network and earn more media exposure. This is one another important thing or the reason why people use it. Now there are some importance of blogs. I have to told you the reasons why people use block. There are some importance of blocks. For example, it refine your thoughts, it reward the creator, or it increase knowledge, connect us to our people, then give introverts a voice, or it is reward the new age publishers, or it open up the world without borders. All these are things which are important things of blog writing or blogging. And now we are going to see the steps before going to write blog or any blog writing. We have to follow some steps. These are some 5 steps, and in this way these are how to write a blog post in 5 easy steps. One step, or the first step, it is plan your blog post by choosing a topic, creating an outline, conducting research and checking facts. So first of all, you have to choose topic, you have to create an outline, and then conducting research, you can add your blog post. The second step is give it an attractive title. So when you write a blog, the title of the blog is very important and should be attractive. Then there is third step, draft a headline that is both informative and will capture the reader's attention. So how the title is important, or title should be attractive, that at the same time the headline also be important. Both it should be informative as well as it should be that type of which will capture the reader's attention. So title as well as headline are important things. The fourth step, have an introduction, lead and concluding paragraph that sums up the blog post, or add your personal experience. So while you complete your blog, while you give your blog on website, it should have an introduction, lead and concluding paragraph. So first of all, the leading paragraph which will lead, or which will be the introductory paragraph, and then there will be concluding paragraph to your blog post. You can also add your personal experience. This is the fourth step. And the next step, use images to enhance your post, improve its flow, or you can add humor and explain complex topics. Use short paragraphs, simple and short sentences and words. So make impressive blog, you have to add these things. It should have flow of importance, improve, how to there should be some humorous things you can add in your blog, and explain complex topics. When you make any write any blog, the sentences, words should be very simple and very easy to understand. You can make here. And the next step you have to follow is edit your blog post. What you have to do here, make sure to avoid repetition. Suppose you have written something, suppose you have made any blog, you have to recheck it if you have made any repetition, and you have to avoid it. Read your post aloud to check its flow. So you can read it, reread it, and you can check its flow. Have someone else read it and provide feedback. So before giving your blog or sharing your blog to website or social media, you can recheck it, you can read it, and you can also take feedback of this blog post. Keep sentences and paragraphs short. It should be easy to understand. If you keep your sentences very short and very easy to understand, make very simple words, simple sentences to use it. It is alright to delete or modify your writing at last moment. End your post with a discussion question. So in this way, you have to follow these steps. You have to follow these things here to make your blog. And when you make this kind of blog, it will be very impressive and it will be very important kind of blog. In this way, in the 11th standard textbook, we have seen very important chapter, blog writing, and how to write blog, today we are going to see some points. There is one question or an activity on page number 104. Given below are some topics of blog writing, and we are going to discuss some points of it. So how to write a blog? I will give you some points here. If you write these points into your notebook, it will be beneficial to you to make any blog writing. So let me give you some points for some blog writing. Suppose, for example, personality development is one of the blog. In this way, when you write a blog on this subject, personality development, which points you can follow here? For example, values. See the points, values. तुम्हाला जेव्हा एक ब्लॉग रायटिंग करायचं असतं तेव्हा एखाद्या विषयावर, फॉर एक्झाम्पल आपण पर्सनॅलिटी डेव्हलपमेंट म्हणजे व्यक्तिमत्व विकास या विषयावर जर आपल्याला ब्लॉग रायटिंग करायचं असेल तर काही पॉईंट्स त्यासाठी असे आहेत जे तुम्ही डेव्हलप करून हा ब्लॉग तयार करू शकता. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, व्हॅल्यूज, जीवनात आवश्यक असणारी जी मूल्य आहेत, व्हॅल्यूज यू कॅन राईट देम. देन देअर इज कर्टसी. One another point you can include here, education, very important point when writing blog on personality development. Important point here is education. Then cleanliness, one another point here you can include health. And one another is social awareness. Look at these points. You can develop your blog, or you can write a blog using these points. Personality development. Very easy to write here. Then there another point or another blog or subject for blog writing, health and fitness. Also, I will give you. You can write a blog on this topic also, health and fitness. This is very important topic in these days. We all have to be aware about our health and what things we should follow for keeping our health good. This is the blog writing. You can write here. So what are the points for this? Good diet. Then regular timings, or you can also write here personal hygiene. Then one another point, regular exercise, you can include here regular exercise. Very important thing you have to follow in these days. It means you can write health and fitness, the blog writing on this subject using these points. One another thing you can add also here, positive attitude. Positive attitude, etc. Look at these points. You can develop a blog by using these points. So in this way, I have given you two points, two subjects to write a blog writing. One another subject I will give you, how to write a blog on communication skills. For example, write write a blog on communication skills. What can you write here? Good knowledge. Good knowledge. Then you can write extensive reading. Extensive reading. Or you can also follow the point awareness of barriers. Barriers. Here barriers म्हणजे काही अडथळे शिक्षणामध्ये येणारे त्याचा तुम्हाला इथं अवेअरनेस असणं महत्त्वाचं आहे. सो कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्सबद्दल लिहित असताना तुम्ही गुड नॉलेज, एक्सटेन्सिव्ह रिडिंग जे वाचन, एक्स्ट्रा वाचन करणं महत्त्वाचं आहे, गुड लँग्वेज, गुड बॉडी लँग्वेज, गुड लँग्वेज और गुड बॉडी लँग्वेज. Then there is courtesy, social awareness. Etc. So these are some things you have to follow while writing communication skills, a blog on communication skills. So I have given you three topics for blog writing. These are personality development, health and fitness, and communication skills. Very important and very easy topics I have given you are with the points. You can write a blog using these points in your notebook. In this way, I have completed blog writing today. Very important topic in your textbook. Thank you.